Hi, this is Travis from POSGuys.com. Today we're doing a very simple demonstration of how to do some asset tracking. Basically, I'm going to scan our break room and a bunch of food items we have left over from the holidays in our break room. I'm going to add them to a Word document, or actually a notepad document, using a CS3070 and a Microsoft Windows tablet. We're just going to scan straight into the document. I'm then going to take that document, put it into Excel, and then I'm going to run some functions on it that will parse together the data and then allow you to have a count of each part number in it. You can then take that part number and import that into your point of sale software or your asset tracking software, and then you'll have updated totals on your inventory. So let's get to it. From Windows, I pulled up the desktop. I have a basic notepad application running, and then I have a CS3070, and I have this in Bluetooth mode. I'm going to use it to do keyboard wedge entry. You can actually just use this and do a straight batch mode and then take the file off of your memory scanner and bring that into Excel as well. But for the purpose of this demonstration, I'm going to use it as keyboard wedge. You don't have to have a Bluetooth scanner. You can use a corded scanner. You don't have to have a tablet. You can just use a corded PC as well. These are all just kind of low-cost options, and you might already have the hardware needed to do some basic asset tracking. So going forward, I'm going to take 3070, and I'm just going to start scanning. I'm going to scan everything once. So as you notice, each time it scans, it hits a carriage return. So I'm just going to go through and scan everything. And then for the sake of this demonstration, I'm going to scan a couple of the items again to basically represent having multiples of the same item. So that's it. What you'll have is a text file of just the different SKUs or UPC codes of the items. And we're going to bring this into Excel and create a asset file with that.
Okay, here we have that file that we created on the tablet. I brought it over into my desktop computer. And that's because we have just a bunch of scans that are just all carriage return delimited. I'm going to Control A. I'm going to copy them all. And then I have Excel going right here. I have a brand new spreadsheet. Select the first column and paste them in. So there we can see all of the values there. I'm just going to name this column. I'm going to call it part numbers. So we have the list of all the part numbers that we scanned. That's useful in the fact that we know what the part numbers are, but we don't know how many we have. So what we're going to want to use is a couple formulas that are built into Excel. I'm going to highlight the column. I'm going to go over here to formulas. And what you're looking for, actually I'm going to go into data, is this subtotal feature. When you click subtotal, it's going to bring up a prompt. It's going to ask which columns you want to do, and it's going to ask if you want to sum. What you actually want to do is count. We're going to count the part numbers, replace current subtotals. We haven't done in subtotals, so it doesn't matter. Summary below data, and that's fine. So we say OK. So now what it did was it created a new column here. And so there's our part number. It says count. And then what happens in this column B is how many we have of each one. But if you look at it, one thing that won't make sense is that you'll see part numbers that we've already scanned, and the count will be one, where we had more than one scanned. So there is one more step that we need to do. So I'm going to reverse this. I'm going to hit Control Z. And we're going to go back to our raw listing. Before we do anything, we're going to need to sort our data. So up at the top of Excel, there's your A to Z sort. So we're going to run our subtotal function again. Our column's highlighted. We hit subtotal, part number selected. If you leave it on sum here instead of count, when you hit OK, it'll appear to work, except that when you look at your count, it's going to be funny. Instead of having like 2, 3, 4, 5, or however number you have, you see a value. If you do that in accident, it's no big deal. Just hit Control Z, get out of it, hit your subtotal function again, and then just remember to hit count. Okay, so now if we check our counts, it looks what we expect to see. We have some part numbers that we scanned 4 times, 1 time, 2 times. So those are the numbers I would expect to see. So we have a sum here, which is useful, but we can't import this into any kind of software at this point. So we'll need to do grouping. One nice feature of Excel is that they do that for you. If you see these 3 buttons that have appeared here, it collapses the data. If we hit number 3, it shows everything. If we hit 2, it collapses it down into just the part numbers that we want. And if we hit 1, then we only see the count for everything. So we have 39 items total. So I'm going to expand this out. And what we're going to want to do is take the data from just these cells. If we cut and paste like this into a new spreadsheet, it's going to take all of the data. So I'll just show you with a click. So we copy, we add a spreadsheet, and we paste. So it brings in all the data. That's not quite what we want. Clear that out. What you can do, though, is highlight the fields that you want. And if you hit F5, there's a Go To option. Click the Special button. And then you're going to do Visible Cells Only. And if you do that, then it only selects what you see on the screen. We copy that over, go to our new sheet, you can select all, and hit paste. So there we have all of our items. A couple housekeeping type of tips. If you look at your cell here, it has the part number and then the word count. You can easily replace that. You just do a find and replace. We're going to do Control F. It's going to bring up the dialog for find and replace. What you're looking to find is the word count. You're going to replace with blank. If you do that, go to replace all. Tell you that it's replaced it 21 times. And then remove that word. So it's just the part number, and then it's just the quantity. Additionally, you'll see a couple fields. They're in scientific notation. If you click on the field, it's the actual part number. So when you export it out, you're not going to see it that way. But if it bothers you, you can go to Format Cells and set it to text, and say OK. And then you kind of got to double click the cell. But once you do so, then you don't see it in scientific notation anymore. So that's basically how you create a part number and quantity spreadsheet. With these spreadsheets, you can then import it into your point-of-sale software, so you can update the quantities that you have in stock. You can also get the total value of all of your inventory. This, of course, is only the part numbers and quantities. It doesn't have the fields like cost, price, or description. That information you're going to have to get out of your point-of-sale software, or you're going to have to use a program like Access the database directly, and then import in your new inventory values. And then when you look at them together, you'll have a total with a total value using that information. So this has been a basic information on how to put together an inventory spreadsheet. For more information, please visit us at POSGuys.com. Thank you.